Dear friends, today we are going to learn about the determination of support reactions of overhanging beams. So that we could complete the support reactions of a particular curriculum based beams, that is cantilever beam, simply supported beam and overhanging beam. So in this determination of support reactions, this is the last session to find the support reactions. So today, so we will see the other types of reaction calculations, so that we will should understand the complete support reactions finding of for a beam. So in order to solve these support reactions, we required equilibrium conditions of equations. That means we are assuming that the beam is in a stable condition under the external loads and the support reactions. Therefore, we are using the sigma f of x equal to 0 and sigma f of y equal to 0 and mz equal to 0 at any point in a plane structure. So today we are also discussing about the how to solve the UDL types of loads given on the beam. Earlier session we solved UDL in a different manner. As it is, we are followed whatever the UDL is given, it has been used in a calculations. Now in this method 2, we are converting the UDL to point load. For that we required, there are two things we should be keep in mind, that is the magnitude and the second one is position, right? So how the UDL is going to be converted into point load in terms of the magnitude and in terms of the position. So we are doing the both. For the in terms of the magnitude conversion to a point load, that is UDL magnitude, that is given like that. What is the UDL generally magnitude? This is the way in generally they will give, like this one, kilonewton per meter. This is the in general UDL magnitude. And what else they are saying, that we should multiply with the occupied length. What is occupied length? So you know that occupied length means it is not the total span of the beam, it is the distance from the starting point of the UDL to the ending point of the UDL. So occupied length is nothing but occupied length of UDL is equal to starting point of UDL to ending point of point of UDL. So this is known as occupied length. Therefore, if in any problem the span is 12 meters and UDL is given up to 3 meters only, therefore you have to multiply it with the 3 meters, right? So that you will get the magnitude, then 10 into 3, 30 kilo Newton. So this is the thing you have to do like this. In this problem, 3 meters, it is a 3 meters. So what is here, it is a 3 meters. So therefore this meter and meter will get cancelled, therefore kilonewtons will be there. That's why it is converted into point load. The units of the point load is only newton or kilonewtons. So the magnitude of UDL is converted into magnitude of point load by multiplying the UDL magnitude into occupied length, right? Similarly, where it has to be placed. Now the UDL, this type of UDL is converted into UDL is converted into point load. Now it is point load. Now in this occupied length, where it should be placed, that is the thing we should know. So this is the given 3 meters. Where it has to be placed, this point load should be placed where? So for the same thing, the point load should be placed at the half of the occupied length. So occupied length is 3 meters, therefore occupied length will be 3 meters divided by 2. So what is the distance? That is 1.5 meter. Therefore you have to place this one from this point to this point. The distance is 1.5. So this is the thing they want to say in this method 2. In method 2, we are converting the UDL into point load. UDL having the two things. One, it is magnitude, and second one is its position. When we are converting to point load, therefore magnitude of the UDL into point load magnitude is equal to UDL magnitude into occupied length. Therefore 10 into 3 30 kilonewtons, and the position where the converted point load should be placed, it should be placed at the half of the occupied length. Therefore 3 by 2, then 1.5 meters. Therefore we are placed the same thing at the half of the 3 meters, that is 1.5. So this is the position of the point load, right? So by using this method too, we are going to calculate the support reactions. So in earlier session, we are solved this problem as a taking a simply supported beam. So with that, we will go further, right? In this problem, there is a UDL of 50 kilonewton per meter. So we are converted the same thing, magnitude of UDL to point load. So we are using the method 2. Therefore, what is the magnitude of the UDL as a point load? 50 into 4, that is 200 kilonewtons, right? So now the second point is where it has to be placed. Position of point load is equal to occupied length by 2. What is occupied length for the UDL? This is the UDL occupied length, 4 meters from this point to this point, that is starting point to ending point of the load of UDL, right? So this point to this point is 4 meters. Therefore 4 by 2, that is 2 meters. So now you please see this figure. This is up UDL. Now UDL is converted into point load as 200 kilonewton, and it should be placed at 2 meters. That means here it should be placed, right? We will see that how it is going to be placed. See the bottom figure. Here the UDL has been converted into 200 kilonewtons. As we know that magnitude of UDL into occupied length will give the point load equivalent. Therefore 200 kilonewton we are obtained from this. And where it has to be placed? Occupied length by 2. So occupied length is 4 meters. Therefore 4 by 2, it should be placed at 2 meters. See this, from this point to this point, it is the 4 meters. So we placed at 4 by 2, that means 2 meters. So from this point, it is 2 meters. Or from even the at end point also, it is 2 meters. So therefore, it is this 4 has been divided by 2. You got the 2 meters, 2 meters. In between the point, we placed the point load. Right? So this is the placing of the an UDL equivalent to as a point load. So with this conversion, the easy to solve the support reactions. So in this problem, they are asking to find the support reactions. Now it is very simple. RVA plus RVB, there are two loads. Here you can see there are two loads, 40 and 200. Therefore 40 and 200 we are taken as a negative, and 240, that is the total. And sigma f of x equal to 0, we are used that one. And the same thing, because there is no inclined force, here there is no inclined force, hence there is no horizontal reaction from the hinge side. Therefore at the support, support here, there is a zero reaction as a horizontal, right? It is a horizontal, there is a zero reaction. And taking for the momentum sigma mz equal to 0, hence taking moment about any one support. So there are two supports A and B, you can take any side of the moment. So we generally take at the support A, therefore sigma ma equal to 0, assume clockwise moment is positive. To get the algebraic sum of thing, this assumption is required. Either you can take a clockwise as moment is positive, or you can take anti-clockwise is also positive. That is up to you, you can choose. Accordingly, you should change the signs. Right. So from the figure given that, so we are following that. We are taking the moments about A, therefore RB from this point, this is an upward, RB is an upward, hence RB to this one, it is an anti-clockwise moment, hence it is a negative, right? RB is a anti-clockwise, hence it is negative, whereas 200 kilometers is going downward, hence downward to this position, it will give a clockwise moment, hence a clockwise moment is a positive, right? And RB is anti-clockwise moment. That we know this is anti-clockwise is negative. And from this point of view, the 40 is also a clockwise moment. Therefore, it is also a positive. Therefore, two positive and one negative. Right? Moment from the support A, it is itself, there is no perpendicular distance here. Therefore, RA into 0. Therefore, RA is not considered here. Therefore, RB into 12, negative, because it is anti-clockwise direction, plus 200 into, 200 is placed where? You can see, 200 is here. Therefore, you have to add all these distance up to support A, 2 plus 1 plus 3, right? So, we are added the same thing, 2 plus 1 plus 3, right? Total 6, right? And similarly, for the 40, it is 3 only. The distance is only 3. Hence, the distance is multiplied with 40 into 3. Right? So, by using these type of calculations, you can obtain the RB value. Therefore, negative values are one side and positive values are another side. You got that total divided by 12. Therefore, 110 kilonewtons. So, this is about the RB. Then, you required RC also. So, this is the simplified procedure, right? Therefore, RA plus RB equal to 240. Therefore, RA is equal to 40 minus RB. So, by solving, you got RA is equal to 130 kilonewtons. RB is equal to 110 kilonewtons. So, this is the method two. It is very simple to get the calculations. All the UDLs are converted as a point load and procedure is as simple as point load procedure. So, there is no confusion how to take the distance, and by adopting the magnitude equivalent to the point load and positioning at mid of the its occupied length as a point load. So, you can solve any type of the UDL problems with this method. So, today in this session, we are also be able to understand the determination of support reactions for overhanging beam. So come join with us, we understand the overhanging beam. Types of overhang beam. There are two types as how the beam is extending over the support. In which side it is extending and in how many ways it is extending. So, if it extends only one of the supports over the only one of its supports, then it is a single overhanging beams. So, here you can see there are two supports. This is the support 1 and this is the support 2. So, this support, after this support also, the beam is extending beyond the support. If you see at the support 1, it is a closing one. There is no extension here. Hence, it is known as only one side it is extending. It's only one of the supports only extending. Hence, this is known as single overhanging beams. Whereas for the second in the figure, you can observe even at the support 1 and at the support 2 also, you understood that there is a extension of the beam at the support 1 and extension of the beam at the support 2. So beyond the support, for the both the beams, we have the extension. Hence, it is known as double overhanging beam. What is going to be actually a double overhanging beam? That we will see. Let we see the another figure of this kind. From that onwards, we will see that. You see, in this particular problem, first you understood this type of problem. So find the support reactions for single overhanging beam as shown in figure. So in this figure, he is giving a simple beam, which is a overhanged beam. It is one side overhanging beam. By observing the figure, you are understood that at the support A, there is no extension beyond the support. But at support B, there is an extension. Hence, it is a single overhanging beam, right? So, you generally assume that if a person is standing like this, if a person is standing like this, you please understood that this is the support 1 and this is the support B. There are two supports like this. If a person is standing and jumping on this one, what happens, right? So this slant or this flank or the beam will bend like this, is not it? It will goes like this due to his jumping action. What will happen? This beam will go like this. At this point, it goes down. Whereas at this support also, it goes upside. You can see this is going on upside. This is also going on upside. Right? So, for this type of situation if occurs, then this support reaction will be, in downward side. And similarly, this support reaction is also in the downward side. So actually earlier what we learned that all the supports will give the upward reaction. But if this is the case, what will happen? The supports will give downward reaction is also be possible. So this is the one of the case we understood that. If we see that instead of bending in this way, if it might be bending in other way also. You can see that also. So if the bending is happened like this, then what happens? If the bending is happened like this, so at this point it is going down, there is no doubt at all. But you can see here at this point, the beam is below the support, which is not good enough. Hence this support will try to push it up. So it will push upside. So this support will give the upward reaction so that the bend will go to the upside, not the downside, right? And for this condition, it is going away from the support. Hence this try to bring down, so this should be come to bring down. So this is the situation will come. So this support try to bring down. So here you can see that at this point it is a downward side, this support, and at this point it is an upward side. So this can be happen depending upon the loading intensity and the load's position. So in up to this time, what we learned that the supports always gives the upward direction reactions, but it is not the same case. So in some cases, it is happened that some supports will be give downward reaction and some supports will also give the upward reaction. So we have to see that which type of support reaction is coming up. So in order to obtain those upward or downward directions, we should assume some of the directions for the calculation sake. After that, at the end of the day, if in end of the problem, if you are not getting the assumed signs, then it means that the directions we are assumed are opposite actually. So hence the assumed directions have been lifted and the opposite directions which are given that should be adopted. So we will see that problem here. So find the support reactions for this single overhang beam as shown in the figure. Therefore, there is a load 90 kN is acting at the free end C, right? So due to this, the moment due to this, it produces a moment over support B, right? So it will undergo rotation, right? It will undergo rotation. Now BC is a overhang portion which is subjected to rotation. Now in order to further procedure, I need to assume, as I earlier also said, that we should assume that both the supports vertical reactions are upward for the sake of calculations. So if RA, RB are upward, that means it is a positive. Therefore RA plus RB and 90 is downward direction. Hence according to sigma Fy, it should be negative. Therefore RA plus RB is equal to 90. That is the equation 1. In the equilibrium equations, there is a second equation, that is sigma F of X equal to 0, which is not applicable for this type of loading because there is no inclined load, there is no parallel load or horizontal load here. Hence, we are skipping sigma F of X equal to 0. Now, taking the consideration of sigma MZ equal to 0, taking moment about any one support, either it might be A, either it might be B. So we are taking about A. Here you can see that about A, this is 90. 90 is coming to the downward to reach the A. Therefore it creates a clockwise moment. So 90 is creating a clockwise moment. Hence 90 is taken a positive, right? 90 into 6 plus 10, 6 plus 4, that will gives the 10, 6 plus 4, that will gives the 10. And for the RB, RB has to, it is an upward direction, hence it is to try to reach from here to A in an anti-clockwise direction. Hence it is a negative, as per our assumption it is negative, right? So here we said that assume clockwise is positive, hence anti-clockwise is negative, RB is taken as negative. RB into what is the distance? 6 meters only. So to reach A, it requires only 6 meters. Therefore 6 meters into RB into 6, and then solve this equation, you will obtain RB is equal to 150 kN. Right? So actually, what is the external load? Only 90 kilonewtons. But what you got? RB is 150 kilonewtons. So it should not be like that. Sigma F of Y obviously should be 0. RB is greater than the external applied load. So that means RA is something that is in the favor of the applied load. So in the same direction, RA is going to be act. So we also earlier see that. Earlier also I said that there might be in some situations it will be like this. Hence the load is like this. If the load is like acting here, so due to this it will bend like this. So at this point the beam is required to push upside, hence RB is acting upward side. But at this time, beam is away from this support point, hence it requires some pull. Hence it is to be brought down. So it should be brought down. So it has to be down. So hence RA is in downward direction, RB is in upward direction. Now RB is given 150. It is very clearly it is given 150. From this point you are know that RB is 150, and this one is, and this one is 90. So for the algebraic sum of sigma f of y, it is very clear what should be the RA. Now what is the RA? Simply 150 minus 90. You can see that this is upward direction, this one is downward direction, therefore 150 minus 90, then you get the 60. So this will be the 60. 60 it should be downward. This one is the downward, this one will be the downward. Both are 150. The upward is 150. Therefore, total match 150 equal to 150. So the same thing by the figure also you can solve the same thing. R with the help of the equation RA plus RB equal to 90, that is the sigma f of I equal to 0. After solving, you got this negative sign. Negative signs means earlier we are assumed that RA is acting like this. So it is wrong. It is a wrong. So what is now? It is acting downward side. It is acting downward side. It is acting downward side. Hence it is a negative sign. Therefore RA is taken downward side, then it is a positive. Right? So that's why we represented RA in the downward side and RB in the upward side, because RB is given positive only, whereas RA is given negative. Hence the direction need to be changed for the reaction at A. So the upward direction has been removed and changed, the direction is downward side for the RA, right? So that is the changes we require to apply. So similarly we can see the other problems. See, in this figure there are two point loads and is given, it is very simple to solve. Use the same equation, support at A and B. At A and B, vertical reaction sigma f of I equal to 0 and RA plus RB 20 minus 40, and both are, it is also a negative. You can see here it is also a negative. It is a negative, right? So negative and negative 60, that is total it is 60. So after obtaining the sigma f of I equal to 0, you are obtained that it is sigma f of I application, you got the RA plus RB is equal to 60 kilonewtons. So then the second equation sigma f of x equal to 0, no horizontal loads and also the simple supports cannot take the horizontal loads, hence no reactions, hence there is no horizontal load here, hence it is a 0. So this is equivalent to the 0, because there is no inclined load, there is no parallel loads, right? There is no horizontal component forces. Hence at A, that is hinged beam, hinged support, hence at support A, the horizontal reaction is 0. So for to solve the RA and RB, we required the third equation, that is sigma mz equal to 0. So taking moment about any one support, take the moment at support A. So sigma ma equal to 0, assume clockwise moment is positive. So why I am giving always A like that? You are more practice the same thing, so that you will be get the accuracy and speed will increase if you taken at the same side. You will also take the supports at B also. You can try it and check the answers yourself also, right? So RB into 7, I am taking this RB towards the support A. Therefore RB into 7, 2 plus 5, that is 7, right? Which is in anti-clockwise direction, hence it is a negative. And the 40 is here, this is the UDL point load, is acting at a point 1 meter from the supports free end C. So it is a clockwise. So it is moving at a clockwise towards support A, hence it is a positive, and 40 into 3 plus 5 plus 2, therefore 10. And 20 is also a clockwise, being a downward force at support A, therefore 20 into 2, it is a positive and the same. So after solving, you got the 62.86 kilonewtons. Ra plus Rb is equal to 60, that you know. Therefore, now you know the Rb. Then substitute in this equation Rb value. Then you got it is a negative minus 2.86 kilonewtons. Now you know that if negative sign means the reaction what we assumed in the upward direction is wrong for the case of the Ra. So it should be a downward. So make change the same thing. Now I changed here as a downward force, 2.86 kilonewtons, which is in a negative direction, right? In the downward direction, right? So whereas the Rb is positive here, hence I keep the same direction in the upward direction. So that is the thing you should understood these type of problems, right? This is very essential to mark the direction for the supports in the overhanging beams. So that's why I've taken the two problems on the same change of sign problems, right? Negative and positive, right? Now the UDL case. So in this session, we are also discussed about the UDL as a method to conversion to the point load. So you can use that method to solve simply and minimize the mistakes. In this problem, he has given single overhanging beam. You can see it is a single overhanging beam. So in which there are two UDLs. One UDL is over the hanging portion, and the another UDL is just attaching to the point load, right, in the span of the beam. Hence, we need to convert both the UDLs as a point loads, right, and fix that position. So for that, what you required for the UDL of 15 kilonewton per meter, this is the 15 kilonewton per meter, to convert into the point load, we need just to multiply it with the its occupied length. So 15 is up to 3 meters only. You can see this is up to 3 meters only. Hence we require to multiply this 15 into 3 to get the equivalent point load. I can say it is equivalent point load. Nice. And position is occupied length by 2. So what is occupied length here? 3 meters. Hence 3 by 2, you got 1.5 meters. So that means your UDL will be converted as a point load, and it is acting at 3 by 2 distance. It is acting at 3 by 2 distance with 45 kilonewtons. And similarly, for the 10 kilonewton per meter, so this is the 10 kilonewton per meter, the magnitude is 10 into its occupied length. What is the occupied length? This is the occupied length, 5 meters. So this is the starting point and this is the ending point. So we can see that starting to ending point is 5 meters, hence 10 into 5, therefore 50 kilonewtons, that is the equivalent point load. And its position is at the half of the occupied length. What is the occupied length here? What is the occupied length here? 5 by 2. Therefore, from this point onwards, it will be like this. So 50 kilonewton will act at 50 kilonewton will act at a distance of 2.5 meters. 1.5 meters. So simply it is acting like this, right? So this is the thing by conversion of equivalent point load of a given UDL. So now the same thing we will show you in the figure. So here it is one of the thing. Okay, you see this figure. So now it has been converted into point loads. So 50 is acting at a 2.5 meter distance and 45 kilonewton is acting at 3/2, that is 1.5 meters distance, right? So there is no confusion now, all are the point loads, so it is very easy to solve. So apply the sigma f of y equal to 0. So in order to get your reactions, therefore Ra plus Rb, both are upward direction assumed. Ra is also assumed upward direction, Rb is assumed upward direction. Ra plus Rb is equal to all of the downward forces summation. Therefore 20, 45, 50, all are in the downward direction, hence it is a negative. Therefore Ra plus Rb is equal to 150, right? So after that, I am checking about the horizontal forces also. There is no inclined force is there, hence no horizontal force. Hence, we are ignoring the sigma f of x equal to 0. So, we are ignoring, hence no reactions for the that point of view. So, we are converted it into the UDL to the point load, equivalent point loads. Now, in order to solve the Ra and Rb, we require to take the moments about the any point, right? Therefore, in generally we are taking at support A and assuming clockwise this moment is positive, then Rb into 6, this is the Rb into 6 which will give us the anti-clockwise direction, and this distance 2 plus 3 plus 1, that will be 6 meters, right? Hence it is a negative, Rb into 6 is a negative, right? And then 50, which is applied here, which is a downward, hence it will reach us to the Ra in this direction. Hence it is a clockwise direction, positive. Therefore, 50 into this 6 plus 2.5, 8.5 meters, right? And similarly for the 45 into 2 plus 1.5, it will be the clockwise moment, hence it is a positive, right? And similarly 20 into 2, because 20 is the load and 2 is the distance, it is also clockwise moment, hence it is a positive. Therefore 3 positive clockwise moments and 1 is anti-clockwise direction, Rb into 6. Then summation and make it into equal to the other sides of the equality, you can get the value of the Rb as 103.75. Then substitute the Rb value into the sigma f of y equal to 0 equation, then you can get the Rb has been get solved, and similarly Ra by the substitution of the Rb, you can get Ra is equal to 11.25 kilonewtons. Here you please observe here, the sign is positive, that means whatever you are assumed, the direction at Ra is upward direction, it is okay, it is a positive. So the assumption is right, hence Ra is also upward side, Rb is also upward side, because in this problem we are not getting any negative sign for the Ra, hence we are keeping the same directions in the upward direction only. Similarly, in the third problem, we are taking it as a double overhanging beam. Procedure will be the same. Either it is a single overhanging beam or double overhanging beam, simply supported beam, or everything, the cantilever beam. Procedure should be followed. Taken to the moment at the support is the good thing to solve the problems, right? And observe the positive sign and negative sign given or your sign notations, and follow the sign notations throughout the problem. So in this given figure, You can observe that, is there any support at A? No. Is there any support at B? Yes. Support at B, there is a support. Here it is a support. Is there any support at C? Yes, it is a support which is hinge beam. Right? Yes, hinge support. Right. Then is there any support at D? No. Support at D, there is no support. So it is a support having at B and C. And so supports are at B and C. Is there any support other than B and C? No, nothing. And is there extension on the one side or double side? You can see at the support B, there is a extension 3 meters beyond the support. Hence, AB is an overhanging portion. AB is an overhanging portion. And coming to the support C side, while going towards the D, it is extending. So hence CD is a overhanging portion. Therefore CD is also overhanging portion. Hence there are two overhangings. One and this one is second overhanging. There are two overhanging portions. Hence you require double overhanging beam solution. Hence it is a double overhanging beam. So procedure will be the same. So what I suggested is apply the method to and get the all the UDLs into the point loads and sigma f of I equal to 0, sigma f of x equal to 0, then sigma mz equal to 0. Apply all those things. So for the use of the method to, so what you have to do that? Each load you need to specify its equivalent point load. Its equivalent point load. Here 25 into 3, because this is the 25, right? This is the 25, and its occupied length is 3 meters. Hence 25 into 3, equivalent point load is 75 kilonewtons. Where is the position? It should be half of the occupied length, therefore 3 by 2, therefore 1.5. So its equivalent point load has been placed at a mid of the at mid of the 3 by 2. So here it will be placed. So what is the intention of it? 75 kilonewtons. Right? So this is the thing you should understand. Right? Now it is converted into equivalent point load and at a distance of 1.5 meters. So here it is 1.5 meters. In the similar manner, the UDL 10 kilonewton. So 10 kilonewton is not there, hence it is 15. So here it is, small mistake has been done. Therefore 15 into 4. So you can see that this is the 25, this is the 25, and this one is 15. Right? Okay. So values are same as in the figure. 15 into 4 is equal to 60. Right? There is no problem in this one. 15 into 4, 16. 15 into 4 is 16. And for the 4 by 2, its occupied length is the 4. Hence, 4 by 2, 2 meters. It is not the like this. So, 2 meters. So, here it will be at the center, it is going to be applied. At the center, it is going to be applied. Right? How much it is? 60. Then solve this one, 60 kilonewtons, and solve this one, converted into same thing. So you can see here 2 meter, 4 by 2, it is a 2 meter, and values are not, we are happy here, values are not disturbed, therefore 4 by 2, 2 meters. And 75, okay, and then 1.5 meter, right? So values are same, hence you can proceed in this problem. Sigma f of y equal to 0, right? Therefore, similarly, rb is upward side, positive, rc is also upward side, assuming that rc is in the upward side. Rb, rc are in the upward side, we are assuming, and remaining all are on the downward side. So hence all are taken as negatives. Then RB and RC, sigma f of x equal to 0, Here also there is no horizontal forces, hence there is no horizontal reaction. Now after conversion of this one, now I can take the moments about B, or I can take moments about the C. Either you can take moments about A also. If I take the moments about A, then what happens? What are the number of unknowns? You please understood this one. If I taken moments about A, there is two unknowns in the equation. Unknowns. Unknowns will come in the equation. That is RB and RC. So if I taken the moments about the A, if I take the moments about A, what happens? I need to take the RB and RC. Both will come in the equation. So so it will becomes increases your solution procedure. So again, after solving this equation, you got in another equation in similarly like this equation. So after that, we have to take it here to RB minus RC some value, and then cross multiplying, then we have to solve. So it increases your procedure. Hence, in order to avoid, I wish to take only one unknown in the equation. Hence, it is a possibility you can take the moment about RB or RC only, so that to avoid the one of the support reaction. So there is a possibility. So it is the possibility. It is the possibility to get the possibility to get the only one unknown, only one unknown in the equation, take moment about any one support. So supports ikkade unnai, either B gaani C gaani. So I am taking towards the C. So that's why I taken about C, right? So you can say here you can need to change this one as C. I am taken towards the B. Taken moments about B here. Therefore, RB into 6 means it is going like this, right? It is going like this. So going like this means simply you should say that taking moments about C. So while you taking the moment about C, this one is going to be a clockwise moment. From RB to C, it is clockwise. RB into C, it is a clockwise. And whatever the other forces, this is the 30. 30 is going from the downward to reach the C. Therefore, 30 into 9, because 3, again, this one is 3, and here it is 2 plus 1. Therefore, total 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 1, therefore it is a 9. And similarly for the 20, here it is 20 is going towards this direction. It is also a clockwise, anti-clockwise, hence it is a negative. Therefore 20 into 6, 2 plus 3 plus 1. And 75, which is here, it is also taking the anti-clockwise direction, hence it is a negative. 75 into 2.5, right? Hence it will be the same thing. And from this point 60, it is going towards clockwise direction towards the C. So this one is clockwise, hence it is a positive, and the distance is 2 meters, therefore 60 into 2. So simply solve all those things and you got the RB value. If I am not taken about the C or B, you got in this equation RC plus RB. So I doesn't want to two unknowns in the equation, hence I taken the moments about any one of the support. In this case, I taken moment about C. So from this equation 1, RB plus RC equal to 185, then this equation from 1 and 2 solve, you got these values, right? Then RC equal to 108.75. You see, observe this one, RB is positive, RC is also positive, that means both are in upward direction. So that is the thing. So this problem we are already solved, right? Now this is the another type of the double overhanging problem. So find the support reactions for the double overhanging beam. Now you can use the method 2. In this problem I am not using the method 2 of the UDL converted into equivalent point load. I am keeping UDL as a UDL only. I am not changing the UDL into a equivalent point load. So the procedure just we are recalling that how to do that one. So in this problem also it is a double overhang beam. So this side A to B, it is a overhanging portion. C to D is also a overhanging portion. Then use this overhanging portions, sigma f of I equal to 0, then RB plus RC, therefore RB is upward reaction, RC here also we are assuming that it is in upward direction, therefore RB plus RC minus 30, and UDL should be multiplied its occupied length to convert into load, therefore 15 into 4. So then RB plus RC is equal to 90 kilonewtons. So in this problem also there is no inclined force, hence we are keeping horizontal reaction at 0 only. And here take the moment about C. So here it is moment about C, therefore moment about C. Therefore RB is going towards the C in the upward direction, therefore it gives the clockwise moment, hence it is taken as positive, and 30 kilonewtons to reach C, it should travel anti-clockwise direction, hence it is a negative, anti-clockwise direction it should be negative, whereas the UDL to reach the C, it should travel clockwise direction. It should travel clockwise direction. Therefore, it taken as a positive. It taken as a positive. And 15 into 4 to convert it into a load, and its point of application is at 4 by 2. Hence, it is a 4 by 2. And the distance from the starting point to the its support point is the same. The UDL starting point is at the supporting point. Hence, we are not adding any distances. So, simply we are giving occupied length by 2. So, that is the distance from the point load, equivalent point load, you can say that, and that distance, that is the 4 by 2. Therefore, 4 by 2 we are used for multiplication, and then solve all the equations. Then you got RB 25.71. It is a positive, hence RB is upward direction. Okay. Then from equation 1, which is due to sigma f of I equal to 0, we know this RB plus RC equal to 90. Then substitute RB value in this one and you can solve. You can get this value, RB is 64.29, RC is 64.29. So it is also an upward direction, hence RB, RC value should be notified. So in this case, it is these values are not the thing. RB is equal to 25.71 and RC is equal to 64.29 kilonewtons. So this is the values. So this is the solution we have to do that. So I am requesting to all of you, please solve your own problems by changing these numerals and distances of span and the location of loads, and such a thing is required to change the given problems into your own dimensions. So it can give the cross check with your friend so that your answers should match. It builds you confidence. So these as per calculator, and while you are noting down the dimensions, there might be some mistakes happens, hence you should be more accurate about those mistakes, right? So in this session we understood the how to determine the support reactions for overhanging beam. Thank you.